Yeah, I am the tax man. I saw the video of me last week dancing, so I'm not going to dance this week about it. But I am the tax man. I'm here with my co-host, Jim Leahy. Our technical producer is Deborah Shiner. And you, the listener.
And now, here's that man with a head just crammed full of knowledge, Mr. Know-It-All.
I love it when the show's just so tight-knit. You know, like nothing is going to show tight like a tiger.
We know exactly what's going to happen every second.
So
we're scripted.
Well, this is not script. Well, actually, ooh, it is. I did bring this up.
It is odd that scripting. Do you script the script? If we're talking about the script. Is that in the script?
I'm off script.
Let's get it.
You flip the script.
So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, deal with your IRS problem today. Get a copy, free copy of your book. Go to freeirsbook.com. One more time, freeirsbook.com. And I'm going to pull another chapter, another question, another page out of the book for you, the listener. Chapter 12, page 61. Can you discharge your taxes in bankruptcy? And Attorney Stephen Leahy, I think this is interesting because on the next segment, we're going to talk a little bit about how you know.
Well, you know, first I want to mention
I'll mention that a little
first
bit.
I want to mention that I have done a CLE, which is a continuing legal education course, where I teach other lawyers how to discharge taxes in bankruptcy. So many people I hear so often, I didn't know you can discharge taxes. I thought you could not. The answer is sometimes you can and sometimes you can't, right? What is the answer, Deborah?
It depends.
It depends is correct because some taxes are never dischargeable. For instance, payroll taxes, what they call a trust fund recovery penalty. That's a payroll tax that you maybe your company had and then they hold you responsible for. That would never be dischargeable in bankruptcy. There's a tax, for instance, if I have a retail store and I have a sales tax and I didn't pay the state of Illinois, that tax would never be dischargeable because those are what they call trust taxes. That wasn't your money, right? You collected it for the state or for the federal government from somebody else, and then you held it in trust and you were supposed to send it over to the government and you didn't. So that's never going to be dischargeable. But some recent taxes are not dischargeable in bankruptcy. So for instance, if I owe taxes this year and I file bankruptcy, that's not going to be dischargeable. So let me give you kind of the three important dates when things might be, you know, income tax would be dischargeable. So the first one is it's got to be due. That tax must be due more than 3 years ago. So 3 years ago, here we are in July of 2019. 3 years ago would have been July 2016. My taxes would have been due, 2015 taxes would have been due in April 2016. So if I didn't file an extension, those taxes came due April 15th. Okay. So even if I did file an extension, they're due. But technically, the tax return wasn't due. So now, as we sit, 2015 taxes would be dischargeable if they meet the other two requirements. The other requirement is the tax return must have been filed more than 2 years ago. So that's pretty easy to know if you mm-hmm. filed your tax returns. I could pull your transcripts. I can find out when you filed your tax returns. And the tax must be assessed more than 240 days ago. So if that's true, then if all three of those are true and I wasn't involved in any fraud or anything like that, then I can discharge those taxes in bankruptcy. So I've helped people file discharge. Sometimes I tell people, sometimes the fastest, easiest way to get out of an IRS problem is to simply file bankruptcy. If I owe the IRS a lot of money and I have a lot of credit card debt and I have a lot of maybe medical bills and I have a lot of other bills, well, then maybe bankruptcy makes sense and I should probably look into bankruptcy. What gets me is that a lot of these outfits that are, you know, we talk a lot about on this show that there's six things you can do if you owe the IRS money. One of those things is file for protection under the bankruptcy laws, and some taxes are dischargeable that
way. Love this. On the back of the book, there's the six things you can
do.
Can I read them off?
No, don't do it because I'm running out of time.
All right.
Okay, so one of the six things is bankruptcy. So if I'm an outfit and I, you know, so I'm calling these outfits to find someone to help me and they don't file bankruptcies. A lot of these outfits aren't even attorneys, which, and those other reasons why I shouldn't hire someone that's not an attorney. But one of them is What if I can only do six things, one of them is do nothing, so then there's five things. One of them is pay them, so then that, and I can't do that, so that, then there's only four things. If one of those four things is filing bankruptcy, and the guy that I'm talking to can't help me file bankruptcy, well, that's 25% of my options are gone. And maybe the best option would be for me to file bankruptcy, but the guy I'm talking to doesn't know anything about bankruptcies and how and filing bankruptcy for taxes. So they can't really help me, can they? And so I'm not really getting the best best advice, because that person that I'm talking to really doesn't understand it, and so doesn't know that that's an option, or doesn't know how to use that option to your benefit, the client. So again, that's why the answer is it depends, but sometimes you can, and sometimes that's the best way. And even now, I just want to touch on this a little bit, because that's discharging taxes under Chapter 7. You could also file Chapter 13 in bankruptcy and file and discharge some taxes, and sometimes that's the way to go. And we'll talk about that in a different. Anyway, I hope that answered the question.
Thank you, Mr. Know-It-All.
Thank you, Mr. Know-It-All. Again, I pulled that question right out of the book, and just reading along, it's just such an easy read. You have to get a copy of your free IRS book. So go to www.freeirsbook.com. One more time, freeirsbook.com. Remember, Opem Tax Resolution is there for you, 312-664-6649, or visit chicagotaxteam.com, or
freeirsbook.com.
And get a copy of your free IRS book. Listen to our sponsors and come right back here on AM560,
The Answer.